From Hollywood, the toast of the Colgate town, starring Dean Martin and Jerry Lewis. And now, your announcer, yours truly, our tennis, grockin', rockin', droppin', people bleedin', and according to Dougal. And ladies and gentlemen, now it gives me great pleasure in presenting that beloved newspaper man, the famous columnist of the Hoboken News, your host for the toast of the Colgate town, Ed Sullivan.
Of the Colgate town. And who are our sponsors tonight, Art Hannes Bowman, Gulligan, 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 Gulligan?
Junior.
Junior.
Well, the Colgate Palmolive Company, makers of Vito, the deodorant that keeps you nose stain dry.
Vito, really big deodorant. Vito, big deodorant.
Now, Palmolive Rapid Shave, it outshaves them all.
Really huge shave from Rapid, a beauty.
Halo, the shampoo that glorifies your hair.
That'll do it every time. I'd like you to try Halo, everybody.
Great new Formula Fab with more active dirt remover than any other leading product.
That's really the big push. Fab. Giant Fab for the better washing. And now, on with Toast of the Colgate Town. Before starting the show tonight, we have some very fine celebrities here in the audience we'd like to introduce right here on this here stage. Seated right here to my right is a really towering giant in the motion picture industry. Real fine performer and a great man, personal friend. Like to have him stand up and take a bow right here in this theater here tonight, in this here audience here tonight. Take a bow, Cary Grant. Cary, stand up and take a bow there. Cary Grant.
Eddie, very nice to be here, Eddie. You mind very much if I say hello to my wife?
Go right ahead.
Oh, Judy. Why do I keep saying Judy? Her name's Bruce.
Thank you, Cary. Big Gramp. Really big star, and on our audience tonight, a very, very famous man. Many of you may have heard of and read it about him and read it and wrote it about him. In Time magazine, really, really big man. Colonel Arthur Wyatt atomic bomb scientist who only last week ignited the really big bomb from Las Vegas. Colonel Wyatt, will you stand up and take a bow, please? Colonel Wyatt. We'd like to explain about the colonel, if we may. You see, in Las Vegas, the colonel walked up 500 feet to the towering tower and was about to ignite the atomic bomb, and it went off in his hand. Broke his glasses. We'd like to introduce, seated out here tonight, really... How did he talk with all of them? Anyhow... Really big star, seated in our audience tonight, one of the great brothers, Marx himself, Groucho, Groucho Marx.
After 4 days in the water and three in the boat, we finally got here. And now, welcome to the Adam and Eve show, You Bet Your Leaf.
Thank you, Groucho Marx. We have in the audience tonight a wee bit of a surprise for you folks. Where you sitting, boy? There he is. Ladies and gentlemen, I can't seem to see him, but we'd like a real hand for a great star, really huge, immense performer, who you've heard many times. It's Mario Lanza right here. Would you please, a big hand for Mario Lanza. Sorry, folks, he didn't show up here either. We'd like to go straight ahead and introduce some of the fine people who we have the good fortune of having here in our toast to the cool geek town. Really big, 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 really big, big star. One of the really big, big stars from 20,000 large leagues under the big sea. The star of 20,000 leagues under that sea, Kirk Douglas. Stand up and take a bow, Kirk, if you will. Good to see you, Kirk. Happy seaweed. In our audience tonight, one of the performers I know is enjoying meeting a real king. Seated in the back of the audience, we have the king of them all, Clark. Stand up and take a bow, Gable.
How are you, son? It's nice being here, old buddy. Scarlett couldn't make it. She's home burning down the house.
Thank you. Thank you, Clark Gable. I see in our audience tonight a real treat for you folks at home watching our show. Two big stars, great zany comedian, wonderful performer, splendid, splendid exhibitionist. I introduce to you those crazy kids, Martin and Lewis, right here. That little one's a cutie, isn't he? And now, before introducing our show, we'd like to remind you that next week on Toast of the Colgate Town, we're happy to announce direct from the Antarctic Circle on this stage 45,000 penguins smoking cool. On this stage here next week, right here on this here stage next week, here, right here on this stage. I see in our audience tonight a real sporting champion, real big champ, towering, stupendous, monstrous, gigantic, big, huge, big champion, big bantam Ben Hogan, a big champ, bow, a big bow. Champ. We'd like to ask, real big bantam Ben to come up here and hit a golf ball right from this stage here on Toast of the Colgate Town. Bantam Ben will hit a golf ball off the nose of any volunteer. Right here. Really big Ben. This is a real big Ben. Champion who'll come up and have this done. We'll get someone, Benny boy. How about it? Someone in the audience, come up. Let's snap into it. How about someone in the audience? We'll get someone, Benny boy. Here we go. We've got to get on with the show. Thank you. All right, yours truly, Ed Sullivan. We'll do it. Don't forget about next week, the penguin. Teeth, you know.
The show.
Without a doubt, you can be the girl without deodorant out. Just use Veto every day. Keep no stain dry the Veto way.
Yes, Veto is so effective in checking perspiration, it keeps your prettiest clothes beautifully no stain dry. In fact, Veto has been certified safe for fine fabrics by the American Institute of Laundering. Veto is so gentle, it's safe for normal skin. Creamy, smooth, and soft as a lotion. Veto works just like a vanishing cream. And it checks perspiration, stops odor 24 hours. So get Colgate's Veto deodorant.
Keep no stain dry the Veto way.
With Veto cream or Veto spray.
Yes, take your choice. Satin soft Veto cream or superfine Veto spray. Either one gives you dependable, no stain dry protection, such as no other leading deodorant gives. Start using a Veto deodorant tomorrow.
Tickets, please.
Oh, my son Jerry has my ticket.
Oh, you're Jerry Lewis's mother.
That's right.
Well, Dean Martin's mother was supposed to be with you.
Oh, she's here in this compartment with me. And her son Dino has her ticket.
Oh, fine.
You know, we're going along on the entire tour with our boys.
Oh, what fun that's going to be. My, what a wonderful Mother's Day present for both of you.
The very best.
You know, the boys on the railroad always watch the program, and we get a wonderful kick out of it.
Oh, when I tell our boys about that, they'll be very happy.
You're lucky to have them.
Lucky? I think we're the luckiest mothers in the world, because they are such wonderful boys.
You well deserve them.
Rat the shave, I'll shave them all. Rat the shave, I'll shave them all. No messy brush, no greasy cream. Use rat the shave in the morning.
All you do is press the top. Instant lather on the spot. Easy on with fingertips. See how fast your razor zips.
Palmolive Rapid Shave outshaves any lather or brushless cream. Palmolive Rapid Shave outshaves them all. Rapid Shave is faster. Instant lather at your fingertips. Rapid Shave saves time. Rapid Shave is smoother. No scrape, no pull, no ouch. Rapid Shave saves face. Rapid Shave is cleaner. Rinses instantly, not messy like lather, not greasy like brushless cream. Rapid Shave saves trouble. Rapid Shave saves time, face, trouble. Palmolive Rapid Shave costs only 79 cents, nearly 3 months' supply of instant lather. For faster, smoother, cleaner shaves, remember...
Rapid Shave, I'll shave them all. Rapid Shave, I'll shave them all. No messy brush, no greasy cream. Use Rapid Shave in the morning.
Get Palmolive Rapid Shave. It outshaves them all.
There you are.
Yes, thank you very much.
You're welcome.
I nearly lost my place. I had a wonderful dinner. I didn't know they served such good dinner in the train.
I really was surprised, too. It was delicious.
Oh, well, we're very proud of the dinners and the service, too. You know, that's all part of it.
Oh, yeah.
You know, I wish I had time and money to do this for my mother on Mother's Day. Wouldn't that be fine? I know she'd enjoy it, but you have such wonderful sons.
Oh, yes. We are very proud of our sons. They're so good to us, aren't they? And they're very good to each other, too.
That's right. Always helping. Always helping.
Oh, yes. You know, I can never forget the day when Dino had his first baby. How your Jerry, how he helped him.
Well, I was there, and I remember.
Oh, that's right. You were there. You know, Dino didn't have enough money to get a nurse.
Can't you keep that kid quiet?
I'm trying to.
You can't do anything right.
I can't do anything. When you were, did you come out of the hospital? I've been doing the cooking, the washing the dishes, the feeding of the kid, everything. What did you do?
Me? I had the baby.
You had to. I was too busy.
By the way, did you mail the check to the doctor yet?
I forgot. I'll do it now, Lola. I'll do it now.
Oh,
You're a chick to the little baby, don't you?
I'll do it now. Anything you say, Lola.
And anything that Lola wants, Lola gets.
Look at the pretty elephant. Pretty elephant? Oh, sweetheart, Mommy here. Oh, my love. Oh, baby, don't cry. Don't cry.
Dean, answer the door. There's someone there.
Am I going to answer the furnace? Answer the door. Somebody's there. I know somebody's at the door.
Oh, Mrs. Lewis, how are you?
Good evening, Mr. Martin.
Nice to see you. I'm glad you got here. You're going to watch the baby, sit with the baby so we can go see the theater, you know?
Oh, Mr. Martin, I'm terribly sorry. I won't be able to watch your baby tonight.
We won't be able to go out. They got tickets.
Well, don't worry. My son Jerome will watch your baby.
Oh, boy, where is he? Where's your son?
Why, he's here. Oh, come in, darling. Come in, darling.
Am I, darling?
Yes.
I'm scared here.
Oh,
I'm scared to be here, Ma. I don't want to be in this place here. I'm scared. I'd lose that man there.
This is Mr. Martin. Say hello, Jerome.
Hello, Jerome.
Honey, you're Jerome.
I'm glad to know you. How about it? I'm getting out of here.
I'm scared of this place.
That's your son. That's fine.
My only child.
Yeah, he would slow up any family.
Jerome, you come over here and sit right down over there. Don't be afraid.
I'm not afraid.
And be a very good boy and take good care of Mr. Martin's baby.
Yes.
And I'll call for you around midnight.
Midnight when it's dark and it's freedom? No, not at nighttime, midnight. Pick me up in the daytime when it's midnight. It's dark with the phantom walking in the street. He'll grab me and squeeze my whole head.
Sweetheart, you have nothing to worry about.
All you have to do is sit. Yeah, but I just sit. Yeah,
stay.
But I
sit. Stay.
That's should I roll over?
No, just sit. Be a good boy. What are you licking my hand for? You're a sitter, not a setter. Now come on, that's Jerome.
Now be good. Yeah. And I'll come back for you later. Jerome,
yeah.
Are you sure you're all right?
Yeah, I'm all right,
all
I guess.
Right. And don't worry, and I'll see you later. Goodbye.
Ma! Ma! Ma!
I'll take care of him. You go
will
on
you?
Home. Yeah,
don't
I'll
worry.
Ma! 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 I want my mother! I want my mother! Come back here! I want my mother! Come back here, Ma! You better take off some weight. You're getting heavy. Listen.
Let me call my mother.
Want to call your mother?
Yeah.
Call her.
Mom! I guess she's not home yet.
You're not home yet.
No, I don't want to be here.
Simmer down. Look.
Simmer down.
Simmer. Look, just pretend this isn't a strange place, Jerome. Pretend it's your own home.
Uh-huh.
Sure. Make yourself comfortable. Look, there's the radio. There's the ice box. There's the sink. Sit down. You always sit in the sink at home?
Only when we have company.
The company left. Come on.
It was a short party without refreshments or anything.
All right, say hello to the baby.
Over there?
Yeah.
Hello, baby.
Talk lower.
Hello, baby.
Softer.
Oh, softer.
Softer.
Hiya, baby.
Hello, baby doc. Mr. Martin, is this your baby?
Yeah, that's my baby. What do you think of him?
What do I think of your baby? You won't get sore?
Of course I won't get sore. Hasn't he got my eye?
Yeah, and he's got your nose, your old one. Listen, Mr. Martin, What should I do with the baby? Like, do anything I have to do with the baby?
To feed the baby, that's all.
Feed it? Where do you keep the peanuts?
The peanuts for what? The peanuts for what?
For your baby.
That's not my baby.
Somebody stole the baby! There she is, I'll get a cop!
Come here.
What do you mean, stealing a kid?
Hold it. This is my wife. Honey, this is Jerome, the babysitter.
Hello, Jerome.
Hello.
Make yourself at home.
Oh, all right.
There's the radio.
Yeah.
There's the icebox. And there's the stove. Sit down. Does it always sit on the stove?
Only when the sink is full.
Oh, you and your practical joke.
Now, look. Jerome.
What are you so nasty? What is she so nasty about?
She's entitled. She had the baby. Look.
Oh. Well, should I get acquainted?
You go on over and get acquainted and see what's going to happen with the child.
Hello, baby. What's your first name?
And I'm
Kingman. And what's your second name?
And I'm
Sounds like your first name. What is the baby's name? Simone?
Simone.
Hello, baby. Nice baby. Baby, would you like some nice bubble gum?
Bubble gum to a kid?
Well, all babies.
What are you, nuts?
No, but I thought it'd be nice.
Kids don't have good teeth. They can't draw any bubble gum.
Yeah, but they can chew with their gums if they want
to. You
want
to kill my kid?
I'm not killing nobody. I thought I was being nice to the baby. Chew it up.
They can't blow bubble gum. The kid.
Well, maybe they can blow a bubble if they try. How do you know if
you're 3 months old, how's that kid going to blow a bubble gum?
If a baby tries hard enough, they can do anything. I heard of it. Did you ever hear the quiz, kids? What's the matter with you?
They can't. They haven't got the air. They haven't got the air to blow it. Oh, boy.
A baby's doing all right with that bubble gum.
You better get rid of this before Lola sees you.
All right. I'll
get rid of it.
Yes,
throw it outside.
I'll just...
Feed the kid.
Wait.
Test the milk. See if it's too hot or too cold. That's the way you test milk, huh? All right, how is it?
I'd like a little chocolate in it myself.
Now feed the kid the milk. No. A different bottle. Be sanitary.
How do I know?
Put your mask on. This is National Germ Week.
Is that good, baby?
I like a little more chocolate. What do you have?
Look how big you got. You look just like your father.
I am me.
Well, how do I know? Ooh, I'm sorry, baby. No, don't leave. Are you going to go? You're going to leave. Don't leave now.
Sure, I'm
going
to
go.
No.
We're going to the theater.
Oh, don't leave me. Ma!
Come here. Come here.
Don't leave me alone.
Don't be afraid.
I'm afraid.
No.
I'm afraid.
Well, I'm not really too afraid.
You're a big boy now.
Yeah, okay.
No.
Hey! This costs 50 cents an hour.
Here's a dollar. I'll take 2 hours worth. No!
Go get the cab.
No.
Don't
leave me here.
Yeah, Jerome.
Please don't leave me here.
Jerome.
Come here, Jerome. Don't leave me here.
Don't persuade.
Don't leave me.
Jerome, look. I got to get my...
watch me.
I'm not interested. If I want to dirty your suede, I'll dirty it. Now, what is that?
Come on.
Don't leave me alone.
I'm not going to leave you.
Don't leave me alone.
Look out. We'll play a game. I'll think of a game.
Oh, boy, a game.
Yeah, what can I think of here? Why do you keep following me?
I'm lonesome.
All right, give me a Have you ever played hide and go seek?
No, how do you play that?
You go into the bedroom, you count from 1 to 100, and when you're through hiding, you let me know and I come and look for you.
Oh, that's a good game. I like that. That's better than sitting on a stove.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
You know the game. Come on,
yeah,
you played it before.
I played that game before.
Gotta think of another game.
Yeah, maybe you can get
another game.
A better game.
Why do you keep following me?
I miss you.
Hey! How would you like some ice cream?
Me?
Yeah.
Oh, I'd like that a lot. Where can I get ice
cream? Get off of the swings!
All right, where can I get ice cream?
Look, go into the bedroom.
Yeah.
And you dial the drugstore.
Yeah.
And you say, hello, would you send me up a fifth of... No, say, send me up a quart, a quart of vanilla ice cream.
A quart of ice cream? Boy, oh, boy, you're a sporty if I ever saw a sporty, boy. You're a regular sporty.
Hey, that'll be $1 for the ice cream.
No, it can't be.
$38, $39, $40, $41.
All right. Here's your ice cream. Eat it.
Thank
no,
you.
No, don't eat it out there. You'll wake the baby. Eat it in the bedroom.
What is this, loud ice cream?
Yes.
All right, I'll eat it soft.
Yeah, eat it soft.
I ran all the way from the drugstore. How about the tip? I heard you were very sporty.
That sure was good ice cream. I finished it off.
I give up. We got 2 tickets for the theater, and on account of you, we can't go because you don't even want a babysitter. You look like you're tired.
Yeah, I can't hardly keep my eyes open.
Oh, you got your brights on, buddy.
Yeah, I'm very tired.
Why don't you go and lie down? Go on.
Lie down inside?
Sure, rest.
Lie down. All right. I'll just take a little snooze.
Take a little snooze. Go ahead. That's it.
Well, that just about does it. He's sound asleep.
Hey, stupid! I got the cab waiting downstairs.
Well, let's go. Oops. I forgot the tickets.
Well, where'd you put them, stupid?
I'll find them. Go down and take care of the cab.
Oh, you're always like that.
Sure. Ooh. I put them in here. Sure. For the ice folly. Oh, no. Good night, baby.
Hey, stupid, you gonna use my cab or not? What's the deal with you?
This poor gal can't do a thing with her hair. Her harsh shampoo makes her hair so dry and brittle. But this smart gal uses Halo. Her hair won't go wild when it's washed. That's right, your hair won't go wild when it's washed with Halo. Halo contains an exclusive ingredient that glorifies your hair, leaves it sparkling clean. Yes, sparkling clean. Shining bright. Brighter than you've ever seen it before. And so easy to set. So easy to manage, right after shampooing. So next time you wash your hair, don't use just any shampoo that might contain harsh and drying chemicals. Use mild and gentle Halo and be good to your hair. Halo is the one perfect shampoo recommended for all 3 types of hair. Whether your hair is dry, normal, or oily, Halo is the shampoo for you. Now, thanks to Halo, your hair won't go wild when it's washed.
So Halo, everybody, Halo. Halo is the shampoo that glorifies your hair. So Halo, shampoo, Halo.
Ladies and gentlemen, we'd like to make mention of the fact that we had a little announcement to make right about here about our forthcoming tour, which starts on May the 11th. May the 11th, correct? Yes, it is. And we'd like to let all the nice people looking in know about the various cities we're going to. We just wanted to make a brief announcement, but our producer, Ernie Glucksman, feels that you should be very, very dynamic and bombastic when you do television, you see. And he thought it would be much better if we would produce it more or less and do it more or less with a colorful effect. Don't you agree that that is smart? Well, we'd like to say that our tour, ladies and gentlemen, commences. Does the commence mean start or finishing? Well, it starts on May the 11th in Kansas City, Missouri, ladies and gentlemen. And we'd like you to know that in Kansas City on May the 11th, we will be at the Municipal Auditorium in Kansas City. That's May the 11th, and we'd like you people in Kansas to come over and say hi. Thank you very much. Oh, boy, we'll have fun in Kansas City with nice girls like that. Wah, 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 wah. And now on May the 12th, oh, look at this. We're ready in Omaha, Nebraska. What a fast trip. We'll be at the Civic Auditorium in Omaha. And you people in Omaha, remember, it's May the 12th. We'll be going there May the 12th. Thank you very much, Omaha, Nebraska. And then from May the 12th, we will get on the train and continue to Des Moines, Iowa, which is a wonderful town. We've worked there just a year ago at the KRNT Theater with real nice people and a wonderful theater. And have you ever been in Des Moines? Oh, what a nice girl this is. Thank you very much. I can't concentrate on my work. On May the 14th, we open, I should say, for the one-night concert tour. Oh, boy, oh, boy. At the Milwaukee Auditorium Arena in Milwaukee, Wisconsin. The city that has the great beer. Have you been drinking? Thank you very much. On May the 15th, we go to the Kiel Auditorium in St. Louis, Missouri. Da-da, da-da-da-da. Oh, it's May the 15th, Kiel Auditorium, St. Louis, and we'll be looking forward to all the nice people at Chase Hotel. Thank you. May the 16th, we go straight ahead from St. Louis, and May the 16th, we stay on the train and we rest with the oxygen tent and we get massages. Thank you very much. They build us up for May the 17th, which takes us directly to Toledo, Ohio, Dean's home state, at the Sports Arena, May the 17th, and we'll see you in Toledo. You're real nice people in all these cities. Thank you very much. We worked in Toledo last year, too. On May the 18th, Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, we'll be at Convention Hall for Father Paul Shogun, a very, very wonderful guy with some real nice ideas. We'll be at the Convention Hall, Philadelphia, May 18th. Thank you. We'll look forward to seeing all you nice people from Philadelphia who's been so kind to us in the past. And on May the 19th, Cambria County War Memorial in Johnstown, Pennsylvania. Do they fix the flood yet? Whatever happened with the flood? Thank you very much. May the 19th. And on May the 20th, boy, we'll be working pretty good. Hello there. Oh, May the 20th. We'll be at the Onondaga War Memorial, Syracuse, New York. That's May the 20th. We'd like to see you there. Thanks a heap. Oh, what a nice girl. And over here is May 21st. Smallest little state in the United States, Rhode Island. We'll be at the Rhode Island Auditorium, Providence, Rhode Island, on May 21st. Thank you, and we'd like to see all you nice people in Providence once again. May 22nd, back to Boston. We haven't written any books, so we'll be looking forward to going to Boston again. The Boston Gardens, Boston, Massachusetts, on May 22nd. I hope this, thank you, tour comes to an end fast. I haven't got any more weight left here. May 23rd, back on the train, resting with sandwiches and all that. Thank you very much. May 23rd, we're going to be traveling. Oh, May 24th, the Edgerton Park Sports Arena, Rochester, New York, the home of Eastman Kodak. Maybe you'll send me a camera. Thank you very much. May 25th, we go on and we open at the Olympic Stadium for one night in Detroit, Michigan, May the 25th. Detroit is my wife's hometown, so we'll see all the nice friends there. And Dean and I have had wonderful engagements in Detroit. Thank you very much. May the 26th, we conclude our tour at the very wonderful Chicago Stadium. On May the 26th, the Chicago Stadium, Chicago, Illinois. Thank you very much. These are one-nighters, ladies and gentlemen. And all the nice people in the cities who have written Dean and I asking when we're coming, we thought this would be the best way to let you know. We start May the 11th. We hope that you will see us. We hope we will see you. And at the end of the tour, May 26th in Chicago, we then come home on May 27th to our lovely wives. That we do on May the
20th. And don't you forget it!
I won't forget it, honey.
It's a hit. It's going, going, it's a home run. And she's one mom who really knows nobody gets clothes as dirty as the Sandlot League. Mom knows, too, that Fab gets clothes the whitest white and cleanest clean you've ever seen.
There's more active dirt remover in Fab, Fab, Fab. Yes, there's more active dirt remover in great new Fab. Fab has more active dirt remover than any other leading product.
Fab washes really white and clean.
The whitest white and cleanest clean.
Get F-A-B Fab.
You see, Fab has more active dirt remover. Only Fab gives you so much active dirt remover plus two such fabulous whiteners. Clothes need no bluing, no bleaching, except for stubborn stains. Fab gets clothes the whitest white and cleanest clean you've ever seen. Yet Fab is milder to hands than even leading floating soaps. So for really white, really clean clothes, get Fab with more active dirt remover than any other leading product.
And now, for a wild, crazy finish, a great dancer and a great talent, Mr. Ray Malone. Here we go!
Milder than floating soaps, milder than cold cream. Milder than beauty soaps, milder than floating soaps, milder than cold cream.
Palm olive proved mildest, palm olive proved mildest.
Hello, I'm Joan Leslie. You know, 9,500 skin tests prove palm olive is milder than any other leading beauty soap, floating soap, or cold cream. Yes, new palm olive soap is milder, better for complexion care. In fact, skin specialists prove new palm olive cleans thoroughly without irritation. See if proper care with new palm olive doesn't bring you softer, smoother, brighter skin. That schoolgirl complexion look. Try new palm olive, cleans thoroughly without irritation.
Thanks once again, Ed Sullivan, and to the Colgate Palm Olive Company for being so nice. We sincerely hope we'll see you on our tour. If not, we'll see you June 5th. Thank you so much. God bless you all. Good night.